Yes, God. Yes, God.
Thank you.
scared. You are my courage. When I'm stressed, you are my peace. When I'm hurt, you are my healing. When I'm lost, you are my key. When I'm mad, you are my joy. When I'm alone, you're my company. And in the storm, you are my shelter. Song. The Apostle James said, when you draw near to God, He draws near to you. We tend in our stresses and in the problems in our life to run away from God because we feel like we're not ashamed to come to Him in that moment. But God, the loving Father that He is always there.
Yes.
In those moments when we're scared or stressed or hurt or mad or alone, those are the moments when we need to press in and ask for more and rely on the Lord.
Yes.
He is our freedom from everything. He is our answer.
Yes.
So when we say we press into you, we're declaring something, but we're also celebrating the love of God and how He shares it with us in our imperfections. We press into you, Lord, when we don't have enough.
Thank you. to get started. He was saying that we press into you, Lord. How do you press into the Lord? How do you press into the Lord? Especially when you don't have no energy. When you've been beat up by a situation. When you're tired. When you feel like the Lord is not even hearing you. How can you press in? So you have to understand one thing. Who are you pressing into? A lot of times we say the name Jesus. And to a lot of people it's just a word now. Jesus. Even when you look on TV, Jesus. Now, it's a cuss word. To the point where people don't reverence that name anymore. Jesus. So what I mean right now, real fast, I need you guys, let's press in real fast. This is our last day out here. God has been so awesome out here. The water is still stirring. You can still press into his presence. But we thank you, Father God, for this day. Yes. This moment. On this opportunity, Lord God,
yes,
Lord, we pray that the spirit of fatigue right now, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Every hindrance spirit right now, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Everything that might try to overload our mind and our heart, Father God, we bind and rebuke it right now, in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
For there's nothing bigger than you, Father God. None of our problems, Father God, can outweigh you, Lord God. So you created this world, created. And so we worship you, Creator. But there's nothing, Father God, that can come against you. You are victorious.
Yes,
you are supreme ruler.
Yes,
you are magnificent.
God.
You are awesome in all your ways, Father God.
Yes.
And here we are, Lord God, pressing in that you may come and sit, that you may suffer, that you may dwell with us.
Yes,
because in your presence there is liberty.
Yes.
There is freedom. There is peace.
Yes.
There is healing. For all that we need is in you, Father God. So, Father God, let us not get weary in the press.
Yes.
Let us not turn to shame when you will reestablish us. Because you so loved the world that you gave.
Yes,
you gave us an opportunity. You gave us a way, Father God, to be forgiven and allowed back in your presence through Christ Jesus.
Amen.
So we press in your name, Yahshua. Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior.
Yes, Lord.
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus. Before we even go any further today, we gotta even understand who was Jesus Christ. A lot of people think, a lot of people call upon a name that they don't even know who Jesus Christ is. Well, understand this. In the Bible it says, in the beginning, God's face was over the deep. But see, God spoke a word. When he spoke that word went out to complete what he said. And he said, let there be light. So let's fast forward to some. Because then it said after God created man, it said that his voice was walking in the cool of the day. Now how awesome is that when you speak and your voice got feet to walk? God spoke and his voice was walking in the cool of the day. It didn't say God was walking in the cool of the day. It said his voice was walking in the cool of the day. How awesome of a God is that? Not only that, and so God showed himself true throughout time. He was the cloud in the daytime. He was the fire at night. He showed himself through the Old Testament many a times. So what did God do? He took his word. Many of us have been on the telephone with somebody. And they might have said, yeah, meet me at the corner store. Meet me at church. Meet me here. And we did it without even seeing their face. But because we knew their voice, we knew their word, we heard their word. You might have been to a fast food restaurant. Can I take your order, please? You don't even see who's talking to you, but you hear a voice. God took his voice, his word. He placed it in the right vessel and allowed his word to manifest into life, to be covered, to walk on earth with men. A lot of people believe, well, God is so awesome, ain't no way he'll visit man. Why wouldn't he? He created man. Why wouldn't he allow a way for his creation to come back to him? So he allowed his creation, he allowed his voice to come into a woman to walk in the flesh. His name was Emmanuel, God with us.